Manhattanville. Manhattanville looking to bounce back this afternoon. Gilman and Carr at the faceoff dot. And the first faceoff of the game goes to the Soaring Eagles. Puck now with Haviland. She takes a shot. Misses wide right. Centered pass by Gilman. One-time attempt by McCafferty misses. Early pressure by the Soaring Eagles in this contest. Big slap shot saved early on by Girardi. Franny Girardi in net for the Valiants. Gloves that one out of the air. Tip out in front of net by McCafferty misses. Manhattanville gets it out of their end momentarily. Lots of offense yesterday for the Soaring Eagles. Nine players with points in that 7-1 win. And as mentioned, Franny Girardi, she is getting the start again against Elmira. Had 46 saves, 24 alone in the third period. So she was tested quite often yesterday, and we'll see what the Soaring Eagles send her way this afternoon. Line change for Elmira. Manhattanville with possession. Turnover at center ice. Puck with Morgan Mordini. She curls around. Centers a pass to Crocker. Pass broken up. Errant pass set up ahead, and we are going to have an icing call at 18:09 in the first period. Goal scorers yesterday for the Soaring Eagles included Holly Riva, Tristan Tolan, Emma Crocker, Kelly Matthews, Jess Adams, and Jenny Heath. So six skaters with goals for Elmira, and Morgan Miller with the lone goal for Manhattanville yesterday. Mordini. Two defenders collapsing on her, but she's able to send it around the boards. Crocker closing in. Morton over to Hansen. She snaps one tipped by Mordini and covered up by Girardi. Both teams going to send five new bodies onto the ice for this faceoff. 17 minutes, 40 seconds on the first period clock. Hoffman sends it off the end boards, collected by Matthews. Matthews curls. She wrists one up high, and she finds the top shelf for the goal. Kelly Matthews puts the Soaring Eagles on top. 1-0. And Elmira with an early lead. Behind Kelly Matthews' goal, she had one yesterday, I believe, in the third period. Yes, she did. Second goal of the third period. And she adds to her goal total. She has scored in each game so far this season for the Soaring Eagles. Here comes Manhattanville with a look. Shot blocked by Harris, and then another shot blocked by Tolan. As Matthews comes back the other way. Showing off the speed. Has one defender on her back. Puck now with Adams. A tip by Tolan misses left. She curls. Was looking at that left post. Couldn't find who was coming in on that play. Looks like it might have been Brooke McCardle. But puck possession back with Elmira Millens. Leaves it for McCardle. Her shot's turned away by Girardi. Might have been going wide anyway, but push it aside for safekeeping. Millens goes cross ice, finds McCardle. She beats one, goes low. The follow-up attempt missed by Meter. Puck was loose, but they whistle it the play dead. Look for McCardle early in this contest. Girardi with a big save. Millens, carry. Big slap shot by Heath misses wide right. Lots of power behind that one. And coming back the other way is Manhattanville. Morgan Miller has it. Sticked away by Heath. Millens up ahead to McCardle. And she's going to dump it in, and Elmira's going to get a line change in. Five new bodies on the ice. We've played about 5 minutes of hockey here at the Murray Center. Gilman has it. Center to McCafferty. Her shot's blocked. Looks like that was Ashley DeFusco who put her body on the line to turn away that shot attempt. Felicio sends it up ahead. Has it broken up. Early puck battles seem to be going Elmira's way. Mary McCafferty has it now. Curls around. Finds Gilman. Gilman goes low. Turned away by Girardi. Good idea by Gilman. There was another Elmira College player crashing on that left side. So better save by Girardi. Had she kicked that further to the left, that might have been an opportunity for Elmira. Lexi Hoffman keeps it in Elmira's offensive end. Crocker slides one low into the right. Clear attempt by Manhattanville. Hoffman there to keep it in. Puck now with Harris. Hoffman, she was credited with an assist on Elmira's game-opening goal by Kelly Matthews. It's her first collegiate point, actually. We've played 7 minutes of hockey here. Elmira with a 1-0 lead. And looking to add to it. Lots of pressure by the Soaring Eagles early on. Nice move there by Manhattanville. Shot goes off the pipe. Looked like it might have went in. And an early celebration by Taylor Hamm, but the officials say no goal. Kind of a crazy play there. Shot from the blue line. Looked like it might have been headed by a Manhattanville player, and you could hear the sound off the pipe. Couldn't really see where it hit exactly, though. Either way, no goal. Elmira maintains a 1-0 lead. Beckman
has her shot broken up by Heath.
And here comes Elmira. Tolan gains the zone. Two defenders on her. She decides to skate around the cage. Up top to Heath. Heath has her shot blocked by Clark. And Morgan Miller is trying to carry it in, but Brianna Haviland on the spot to turn it away. A good look there, but unable to collect the pass. Tolan trying to find McArdle in the center. Big slap shot goes high. Headed away by Lizzie Hansen. 11:25 on the game clock. And we're going to get an icing call. 11:14 to go in the first period. Kelly Matthews with the lone goal through the first period so far. Assists on that goal going to Lexi Hoffman. Her first collegiate assist, her first collegiate point. So congratulations, Lexi Hoffman. Face-off win by Elmira and a quick shot by McArdle, saved by Girardi. Another save by Girardi. That shot coming from Claire Meter. Manhattanville trying to go the other way, but Elmira all over them. Meter and Edgington closing in on that play. As Hansen collects the puck for the Soaring Eagles. Meter able to maintain the puck after losing it momentarily. Tiana Lopes has it taken away by Hansen. Hansen up ahead to Riva. 2-on-2 opportunity for Elmira. Low shot by Riva, sticked away by Girardi. Martin Yeti shaking off a pair of Elmira defenders, but Soaring Eagles able to close in and force a turnover. Riva goes to the backside of her blade. I don't know if that was on net or not, but a good idea on that attempt. Anna Tittman able to shake off Hoffman, but Hoffman able to get that puck off of her. 9 minutes, 30-ish seconds to go. Devin Gilman, does she find it? And she does. Gilman with the goal at 9:34 in the first period. Devin Gilman able to put the Soaring Eagles up ahead 2-0. Girardi seemed like she might have lost the puck on that play a little bit, and she was beat low and to the right side. As Devin Gilman, the senior from Yorba Linda, California, scores her first goal of the 2020-21 season. This face-off. And another face-off win for the Soaring Eagles. Puck with Bowden. She goes high, just misses. I'm sure if you could hear those assists on that last goal, but they went to Mary McCafferty and Sydney Harris on the Devin Gilman goal. Soaring Eagles lead 2-0, just under 9 minutes to play. Manhattan turnover results in Jenny Heath trying to gain the zone, and she does. Has one defender on her back. Looks like it's Kerry Carr, and Carr.
Kelly Matthews. Big slap shot by Heath, sticked away by Girardi. Center pass, one time by Tolan, misses to the right. Puck back with Heath. Now to Haviland on the right side. She goes cross ice looking for Matthews. Matthews able to collect it. She turns, she's got a defender on her, ends up losing it. Puck now with Hannah Beckman. And she's just going to dump it in for the time being and get five new skaters on the ice for the Valiants. Under 8 minutes to go in the first period. Matthews beats one. Centering pass to Adams and a breakup on the pass. I think that might have been Martin Yeti that got her stick in there. Backhand attempt turned away by Bella Hansen, actually. No shot on goal for Manhattanville on that one. Line change for Manhattanville. 7 minutes to go in the first period. Pass looking for Claire Meter. Isn't going to get to her, and we're going to have an icing call at 7 minutes and 1 second on the first period clock. In case you're just joining us, Elmira with a 2-0 lead. Goals in this afternoon's contest coming from Kelly Matthews and Devin Gilman. Both even strength goals. A face-off win for Manhattanville.
Meredith has her shot attempt broken up at the blue line. As Claire Meter goes the other way, she takes a big hit right in front of the official. And we're going to have a call. And Claire a little slow to get up, but she looks like she's doing okay. As the officials discuss what's going to happen next. And Meter's back on her feet, just catching her breath. So no penalty on that play, but a faceoff coming up. And a faceoff win for Claire Meter. Morton looking for McArdle, and McArdle takes a dive to the ice. And a delayed penalty call coming up. Puck with Meter. Elmira has six on the ice at the moment. Hansen over to Martin. A tip close to the mouth of the goal misses wide right. And we are going to have a Manhattanville penalty and an Elmira power play here shortly. Let's see what the call is. It's going to be tripping on number 16, Faith Harris. And the Soaring Eagles are going to take to the power play. They had some success yesterday, went on the power play four times, scored twice in that 7-1 win, and they're going to look to continue that this afternoon. Errant pass by Gilman. Elmira's going to have to regain that zone and set things back up. Puck at the point with Adams. She slides it to the left side, back to her at the UCHC logo. She's able to keep it in. Bowden. One-time attempt by Adams is blocked out in front of net. And puck cleared by Manhattanville. Yesterday's power play goals for Elmira were scored by Crocker and Heath, as Elmira looks to add to their power play goal total on the season and add to their 2-0 lead. 1 minute left to go on the power play. Shot by Crocker goes high up into the netting as the whistle stops the play. 5 minutes, 19 seconds on the game clock. Girardi facing a lot of shots already this period. She has seen 13 come her way and has stopped 11 of them. And a clear by Manhattanville. Important faceoff win for them. Just under 50 seconds to go on the power play for Elmira. Riva able to skate in. Tolan carrying. Leaves it for Hansen. Over to Heath with a big one-timer. I think Taylor Ham might have got a piece of that as it didn't make its way to net. 25 seconds to go on the power play. Riva finds Heath on the right side. One-time attempt by Hansen. Goes off the left pipe. Lots of one-timers from the blue line by Elmira on this power play. And about 5 seconds to go on the power play. Heath with another attempt. Huge slap shot block. Tolan with her shot block. As Harris is back on the ice and the power play is over. Loose puck in front of the goal. And no goal. It doesn't make its way in. A good job by Manhattanville to keep it out of the net. Girardi was sprawled out on the ice. It somehow got through her and was just waiting there to be punched in, but Manhattanville doing a good job to recognize the danger and put some bodies on it. And here come the Valiants. Martin Yeti skating. She sends a low shot that's gloved by Hansen. Routine save for the senior goaltender. I think that might be Manhattanville's second shot of the game. Elmira with a 14-2 lead in the shot count. Edgington played off the board to ourselves, but a good play on defense by Manhattanville to stop that rush. Turnover. Oh, and we have a whistle. We're going to get a tripping call, and that's going to go against Lexi Hoffman. 3 minutes, 25 seconds left in the first period, and the Valiants are going to go on the power play. They had two opportunities in the second period in yesterday afternoon's contest, unable to find a goal on either attempt. Their lone goal coming from Morgan Miller in the third period as they look to cut into Elmira's lead and trim it in half. Shot from the blue line misses wide. Kept in the offensive end by Lopes. Puck back with Lopes at the left dot. She goes up over the shoulder of Hansen for the power play goal. Tiana Lopes goes top shelf. 2-1 Elmira. A good look for Manhattanville and a nice change of pace for them. As they get right back in this contest in the first period, behind Lopes on the power play. No one really around her when she got into that area. And she had a clean look. Lizzie Hansen unable to react to that one as it went up over her shoulder. And we have a tight game early in the first period, or late in the first period, I should say. Shot from Crocker, turned away. Puck with Bowden. She swipes and misses. Davies carrying for the Valiants. Puck now with Crocker. She pushes it up ahead to Bowden. Bowden to Mardini. They can't connect. Two-on-one opportunity for Elmira. Mardini had to Bowden. Bowden tried to go back to her. Couldn't find her on that right post. Dangerous opportunity for Elmira. Puck in the neutral zone. Now with Manhattanville. Tiana Lopes. She had the power play goal just about a minute ago. And looking to add to that total, unable to. Puck with Elmira. Jess Adams carries. Leaves it for Tolan. Tolan's pushed off the puck, and here comes Lopes the other way. Flips it up ahead to Stanwood. But Adams closes in and takes it away. Puck nearly goes into the Manhattanville bench. Stays in play. And Manhattanville's going to switch up its two defensemen. Just about a minute to play here in the first period. Elmira with a 2-1 lead on the Valiants. We have a penalty coming up. And some extracurriculars after the whistle. And there's going to be two penalties on this one. It's going to be Kelly Matthews for Elmira and Anna Tittman for Manhattanville. There's going to be a lot of ice out in play here as we have 4-on-4 hockey. And we'll take a listen here who the penalties or what the penalties are.
Kelly Matthews, 2 minutes for roughing. The Manhattanville's number 21, Anna Tittman, 2 minutes for interference. Time of the penalties, 18 minutes.
So Tittman for interference, Matthews for roughing. And we have less than a minute to go in the first period. Wind up by Heath. She misses wide right with a laser. Gilman circles. Sends it over to Hanson on the right side. Hanson with a slap shot. That one also looks like it might have went off the pipe. So Bella Hanson, she's had two shot attempts that have both caromed off the post in this first period. Heath coming back the other way. She had a power play goal last night. 15 seconds to go. Taylor Ham winds one up. Misses high off the glass. Pushed back behind the net by Hanson. As the first period draws to a close. As Emma Crocker and Morgan Miller take the faceoff and a win for the Valiants. Bowden has it for Elmira. Leaves it for Morton. Morton carries. Looks like she might have attempted a shot there, had it broken up. 25 seconds to go on 4-on-4 hockey. Ganesh trying to get it into the zone, unable to due to the pressure from Elmira. Good play by Crocker to get up ahead to Bowden. She tries to beat one. Decides to slow it up instead. Waiting for teammates. Morton.
Both teams have returned to full strength.
Has a defender on her back, and Tittman takes it away. And we are back to 5-on-5 hockey. Bowden tries to deke one, can't do it. The tip from the right side misses just wide. Good look for the Soaring Eagles. One time attempt by Bowden from the slot, snuffed out by Girardi. Pass sent up ahead to Reba. She curls into the center and hits the ice. No call. Puck going back the other way. Ref's hand is up. And we're going to have an icing call with 18:14 on the clock. Allmyer with a 16-3 lead in shots on goal, but just a 2-1 lead on the scoreboard. Heath at the point sends one in. Collected by Gilman. Centers. Now at the point with Haviland. Over to Gilman, who misses the one-time attempt. Good idea from Gilman, who already has a goal today. And another penalty coming up, and another power play coming up. It's going to go against Faith Harris. 2 minutes for tripping. Allmyer going to go on the power play for the second time this afternoon. Came up empty on their first try, whereas Manhattanville cashed in with the extra skater from and a goal from Tiana Lopes.
Valiant penalty to number 16, Faith Harris, 2 minutes for tripping.
Tolan.
That's Harris for tripping.
With a defender all over, that's Marin Yeti. Martin Yeti, excuse me, on her back, but she's able to get out of there. Puck with Hansen at the blue line. Over to Matthews, back to Hansen at the point. She sends one, I think went off of the body of, or the leg of Tolan. But Allmyer able to maintain possession. McCafferty with it now. Looking to set something up. Over to Heath, who risks one. Broken up by a Manhattanville defender in front of the net. Looks like that was Ganesse. Maybe that got a body on it. She's shaking off her wrist. Maybe it was hit her hand. Either way, did not get through to Girardi. Puck back with Heath. Sends a hard pass over to Matthews. Centering pass broken up by Ganesse again. Now Hansen. Back to Matthews. The pass just a little offline. And Manhattanville's going to get a clear. Morgan Miller with the clear. And the Valiants are going to switch up their lines, as will Elmira. Turnover on their own end. And a big hit by Jenny Heath, almost out of necessity, with the puck being that close to their own goal. And Heath's going to get called for body checking. So we're going to have 4-on-4 hockey for the next 42 seconds. And then the Valiants will go on to the power play, assuming no other penalties occur during that time.
Elmira penalty to number 5, Jenny Heath, 2 minutes for a body check. That's Heath with a body check. Time of the penalty, 3 minutes, 22 seconds.
Mordini up ahead to Bowden. She's got Mordini on the other side. Can't find her. Good breakup by Manhattanville. Looks like that was Carrie Carr that broke up that pass. Ham sends one in and blocked by Hansen. Hoffman's going to skate into the zone, and Manhattanville's going to go into the power play at this point for the next minute and 15 seconds. They already have one power play goal, that one coming from Lopes in the first period. Meredith sends across ice. She had pressure from Adams. Puck now with Lopes. Lopes was looking up ahead to DeFusco, or maybe it was Carr, and they were actually hopping off the ice. There was a line change taking place. And Elmira's able to clear its zone. Elmira able to clear it after a few swings. 20 seconds left on the power play. Puck with Manhattanville's Clark. Martin Yeti sends it around the boards. Adele Clark closing in. Has Sydney Harris to deal with, though. Three Manhattanville skaters able to get the puck off of Harris as the Manhattanville power play ends. And we're back to 5-on-5 hockey. Puck with Miller. She sends a shot in. Has it intercepted, actually, by Hansen. Loose puck in the slot. Another shot attempt broken up by an Elmira defenseman. I think that was Sydney Harris. Now McCafferty with it. Leaves it for Millens. Millens tries to go up high. Looks like it was saved. Scrum in front of net. Lots of bodies. Turnaround shot by Adams. Can't find it. And it's covered up by Girardi. Manhattanville bench holding their breath on that. Couldn't really see the puck for a good chunk of that play, but Girardi there to cover it up and get a faceoff. Faceoff win for the Soaring Eagles. Hoffman, she sends a shot in. Tricky one. Took a weird bounce off the ice, but Girardi able to handle it. Puck back with Hoffman. Centering pass and a goal from the slot from Claire Meter to put the Soaring Eagles up ahead 3-1. Claire Meter with the goal. A good heads up play by the Woodbury, Minnesota native. She got the pass in the slot, turned, went with the backside of her blade up over the glove of Girardi for the goal. That's Meter's first of the season and her sixth of her Elmira College career. Soaring Eagles with a 3-1 lead. Puck back with Millens, who was credited with an assist on that goal, as was Lexi Hoffman, her second assist of the game. Hoffman with it again. Sends a shot, turned away by Girardi. Meter back to Hoffman. Hoffman sends one in. Somehow snuck through. Not sure how it did. There were several bodies, and Girardi was there, but it somehow made its way through. But Manhattanville able to get it out of their end. Meter up ahead to McCardle. Now with Millens. And she's going to dump it in. Elmira's going to get five new bodies on the ice. Tippmann sends it in. Pocket at the neutral zone. As Manhattanville tries to get in and errant pass turns into an icing call and a defensive zone faceoff coming up for the Valiants. 12 minutes, 19 seconds to go in the second period. Soaring Eagles with a 3-1 lead. Claire Meter with the most recent goal and the only goal of the second period thus far. Heath fires one in, chased down by McCafferty. McCafferty to Haviland. Haviland goes up high and she goes top shelf for the goal. Brianna Haviland with her first goal of the season. And Elmira now with a 4-1 lead after that goal from Brianna Haviland.
Elmira comes goal to score.
She went top shelf beating Girardi. And it sounds like Holly Reba's gonna get an assist on that goal. A shot from the right post saved by Hansen. Dangerous opportunity for the Valiants, and Elmira comes back the other way though. Mardini's pass broken up. Crocker looking to tiptoe in, but sticked away by Girardi. Taylor Ham's shot snuffed out by Hansen. Bowden sends a pass up ahead looking for Mordini. Mordini able to get there. About 10.5 minutes to play in the second period. Crocker battling for the puck along the boards. And it's pushed up ahead by Charlotte Stanwood. Now with Hansen. Matthews. Now with Tolan. Morton's pass sent up ahead to Matthews, broken up, but Tristan Tolan able to collect and get into the zone. She fires one, headed away by Girardi. Martin Yeti slides it around the boards. Stick lift by Tolan with the takeaway. Some good passing for Elmira sets up an opportunity. Low lining shot by Adams misses wide left. Harris, she sends one low. Sticked away by Girardi. Collected by Matthews. Matthews looking for Adams, finds her. Now up top to Harris. Harris holding, finds Hoffman, now to Adams, somehow finds Harris, low shots kicked away by Girardi. Good job by Girardi to make that save. Lots of bodies in front of her, unsure how she was able to even see it. Under 9 minutes to play in the second period, Soaring Eagles with a 4-1 lead. Turnover. Collected by Tolan. She goes low. Her shot's kicked away. Rebound leaks out to Matthews. Matthews curls. She's looking for that left post. Couldn't find it. Puck collected by Heath, who sends it in. Elmira gets a line change. In the meantime, Haviland collects. She scores Elmira's most recent goal. Her first of the season. And the third of her career. We're going to get a face-off in Manhattanville's defensive end. Just about 8 minutes to go in the second period. Elmira with two goals in the first and two in the second. And that's how we got to this 4-1 scoreline thus far. McArdle goes off the glass looking for Meter. Meter able to chase it down, or is trying to chase it down with a couple of Manhattanville bodies on her. And let's see what the call is. We're going to have interference call coming against Manhattanville, and it's going to go against number 16, Faith Harris. She's going to get 2 minutes for interference, and Elmira's power play is going to hit the ice once again.
Valiant penalty to number 16, Faith Harris. 2 minutes for interference.
Puck with Gilman. Her pass broken up. Kept in by Adams. Over to Mardini on the left dot. And with Crocker, she circles around. Sends a low lining shot kicked away by Girardi. Kept in by Mardini to Crocker. Back to Mardini. Left for Gilman. Now with Bowden on the right side. Bowden looking for Mardini, finds her. Centering pass broken up. Now at the point with Adams. On the left side now with Mardini. She's going to take a shot. Saved. Followed up by Crocker. And we have a goal. We're waiting for that call. Kind of a slow building celebration there. But Emma Crocker is going to score a power play goal for the Soaring Eagles with 6:59 on the clock. And the Soaring Eagles are going to take a 5-1 lead. That's Crocker with the goal on the power play. 6:59 on the clock. And we're going to get a timeout from Manhattanville. We're going to wait and hear who these assists go to. But Emma Crocker scores on the power play for the Soaring Eagles. And it's her second power play goal in as many days. She had one yesterday to start off the second period for Elmira. So a really good back-to-back performance from Crocker as we wait for this timeout to end to get back to action here at the Murray Athletic Center. So Morgan Mardini is going to get an assist on the power play goal by Crocker. The two Massachusetts natives connect for that tally. Turnover in the zone now with Millens. Millens carries, has her shot gloved by Girardi. 6 minutes, 25 seconds to go in the second period. Penalty and another power play coming up as McArdle hits the ice. Let's see who this one goes against. Looks like it's number 24, Charlotte Stanwood. And she's going to get 2 minutes for tripping. So Elmira going back on the power play after scoring on the power play just about, 40 seconds ago? Soaring Eagles looking to build on their 5-1 lead. Puck over with Hansen. She's going to carry it in. She takes a low shot. Followed up by Tolan for the goal. Soaring Eagles score on the power play to make it 6-1. This one coming from Tolan off the rebound. Soaring Eagles lead 6-1. Back-to-back power play goals for the purple and gold here at the MAC. And a face-off win from Ira following that power play goal from Tristan Tolan. Here comes Meter. She's got Edgington on the right post. And a good play on defense by Holly Meredith to poke that one away. Harris and looks like it was Maddie Davies got tied up on the right side off screen before the offsides call was made. And we have another faceoff coming up. Again, that was Tristan Tolan with the power play goal. She had two goals yesterday, so make it three against the Valiants so far in this two-game home-and-home series in UCHC action. Puck battle right in front of the penalty box, and Claire Meter's going to come away with it. One defender on her. She misses to the left, but it goes high off the glass. And Elmira able to keep it in the zone. Good play by McArdle. She whips one in. Ashley DeFusco looking for Davies. And Emma Edgington there to take the puck off of her. Puck back with DeFusco. She's going to dump it in, and Manhattanville is going to get five new bodies on the ice. Here comes Holly Riva. She beats one. Tries to take on three other defenders, but has the puck taken off of her. McCafferty. Now Gilman. Puck with Martignetti. Pushed out to the neutral zone, collected by Hansen. Morton. Up ahead to Gilman. She's got she's got McCafferty on the right side. McCafferty takes a shot, saved by Girardi. Good play by Elmira on that one. Riva to Morton. Morton's going to send it off the boards. Martignetti chasing. And she's going to push it off the boards and into the neutral zone. Matthews with it. Now with Morton. Morton's going to take a shot and misses wide right. Hansen unable to keep it in the zone as it leaks into the neutral zone area. Collected by Kelly Matthews. She's got a goal already today. Soaring Eagles with a 6-1 lead. Mimicking yesterday's scoreline, 7-1, when they defeated the Valiants on Manhattanville's home ice. Puck now with Hansen at the blue line. Big slap shot. Misses high and goes up into the netting as the whistle sounds. And we're going to get a faceoff with 3 minutes and 8 seconds to go. Face-off win for Elmira. Puck with Heath. She pushes in with the backside of her blade. And here comes Manhattanville. Adams has Matthews on the right side. If she can find her, she looks for it. Can't get it to her. Good idea from Adams. Matthews with it now, has Adams on the other side, but we're going to have a whistle. They're going to call hand pass. Adams wanted that one. If there was no call, Matthews was able to get it to her. She had a wide open goal. But that is not the case right now, as we have a face-off in the neutral zone just outside of Manhattanville's defensive end. Shots so far through one period and almost two full periods of play, 34 Elmira, 7 for Manhattanville, as an attempt by Manhattanville is blocked. Puck now with Harris. She finds Hoffman. Sends it up ahead to Bowden, who tips it. We have Meredith chasing, collecting. She looking for a teammate, can't find her. Puck back with Elmira. Bowden. Sends across to Crocker. Her shot's low, misses. Swing and a miss for Bowden. She was able to connect. That would have been a goal. It was wide open on the left side. Minute 40 to go in the second period. Mordini chips out to herself. It's a 3-on-1 if they can. Now it's back to 3-on-2. Buck with Bowden. Now with Crocker. To Morton. Morton takes a slap shot. Sticked away by Girardi. Puck back with Morton. She sends another shot. That's kicked away by Gnest. To Fusco. Beats one. Has it sticked away by Morton. Up ahead to McArdle. McArdle's got Millens on her other side. Can't find her. She takes a shot on goal instead. Centering pass. No one home to collect for Elmira. And Meg Stacy tries to get it out of her end. Has it taken away by Kelly Millens. Millens, she heads in. And around the goal, 30 seconds to play. Puck now with Hansen. Her shot, I think it might have been blocked by Claire Meter. We're going to have a penalty call. Let's see who it's going to go in against Manhattanville. We'll see what Elmira does. They could very easily just sit on this puck and have the full 2 minutes on the power play to start the third period. It almost looks like that's what they're trying to do, but they do lose possession as the whistle is sound, and it's going to go against Ashley DeFusco. Let's see what this penalty's for. She's going to get a minor for high sticking 2 minutes. Soaring Eagles going to head on to the power play once again. Soaring Eagles looking to add to their goal total and to their power play percentage. With another power play score here. Puck at the blue line with Gilman. She sends it over to Mardini, now at the point with Adams. She's going to take a slap shot. Misses wide left, not by much. Kept it in by Adams, now with Mordini, now to Crocker. Sent cross ice. Shot with Bowden, then almost went in. Now it, trick shot goes off the bar. Weird couple plays there. Two almost went in. Gilman. Still with it. She curls into the slot, sends up to the right face-off dot to Bowden. Bowden carries, sends a low-lining shot, and she scores somehow from that angle. And Elmira adds to their power play goal total, and they make it a 7-1 game here at the MAC. There's just 39, 40-ish seconds left on the power play. Bowden able to cash in. Eliza Bowden with her first goal of the season. And it comes on the power play.
Elmira College goal on the power play scored by number 25, Eliza Bowden. Assisted by number 17, Jess Adams. That's Bowden from Gilman and Adams. Time to go on the power play, 1:18 of the third period.
So here we are at 7-1, same score as yesterday, but we still have 18 minutes and 27 seconds to play. a faceoff win for Elmira. Here comes Ham. He's able to fight off a few Elmira skaters and still has it. Slides it over. One-time shot from the right side. Covered up by Champagne. A good save by the rookie netminder. That was a difficult attempt, but she was all over it. 17 minutes, 57 seconds to go here in the third period. Lexi Hoffman sends it around the boards looking for Edgington. Now it's out with Claire Meters. She has a goal today. And covered up by Girardi with 17:30 on the clock. All three Elmira goalies seeing action this weekend. Maggie Gilman saw about 15 minutes in net yesterday for the Soaring Eagles. And today it looks like Catherine Champagne's going to get maybe the entire third period in her collegiate debut. McArdle able to get around Miller. She gains the zone, but they're going to call offside. She had Meter on that play, just maybe half a stride off. And we're going to get a face-off as both teams switch up their lines. Face-off win for the Valiants. Martin Yeti up ahead to Tittman. Had her pass broken up by Meter. Meter slides at cross ice to McArdle. Was looking for Meter again in the slot. Couldn't find her. Puck back with Manhattanville. Heath looking for McArdle. Can't find her. And a puck battle in the corner. Got four bodies on it. No real progress being made yet. And it leaks out. Meter collects. Here comes Manhattanville. And a good play by Haviland to break up that 3-on-2. And Jenny Heath looking to go the other way. She's going to dump it in. ...16 minutes to play here in this third period. Elmira with a 7-1 lead. Two goals in the first, four in the second. And a power play goal here in the third period to get to that scoreline. Tiana Lopes with the power play goal for Manhattanville. That one coming in the first period. It was 2-1 at that point. And we're going to get a tripping penalty against Elmira. Manhattanville is going to go back onto the power play. And we're just waiting on the whistle. There it is. And at 15:36 on the game clock. Holly Reba going to go to the sin bin for this one. 2 minutes for Trippy. And Catherine Champagne going to... assumed is going to face some shots here. See some real action in net.
Elmira penalty to number 20, Holly Reba. 2 minutes for tripping. That's Reba for tripping. Time to the penalty. 4 minutes, 24 seconds of the third period.
And we have a goal right there. Let's see if it stands. It's a slap shot. Looked like it might have been tipped in just from outside the mouth of the goal. Doesn't look like Champagne likes the call. thought there might have been interference on it. But either way, Manhattanville going to get back on the board with a power play goal. It's 7-2, 15 minutes, 10 seconds to play in the third period. So Lopes is going to get credit for her second power play goal of the game, and we have a two-on-one with Mordini and Crocker. Puck with Crocker. Mordini couldn't find her. That's just a little too far out in front. And we have an icing call coming up here shortly. And there it is. An offensive zone faceoff for the Soaring Eagles. Amaya missing out on a two-on-one opportunity. Crocker and Mordini. Good look, but you have to imagine they keep up that pace, they'll see that look one more time before this game ends. Shot looking like that one looking like it was going to go wide anyway, but gloved by Girardi. And another faceoff coming up, 14:39 on the clock. Hansen throws one in. Looked like it might have went off the knee of Crocker. Mordini sends it up top to Morton, and her pass is broken up. Bella Hansen carrying. She takes a little shoulder there, but maintains possession for the Soaring Eagles. Morton able to chase that down, send it in around the boards, and she's going to head off the ice as Jenny Heath enters. Puck with Hansen. Crocker finds the slot, goes to the backside of her blade. Follow-up shot by Mordini, and that's in for the goal. Morgan Mordini finds the back of the net for Elmira's eighth goal of the afternoon, her first of the season. Gotta believe that Emma Crocker will get an assist on that goal. Looked like her shot was initially saved by Girardi before Mordini followed it up and punched it in. Soaring Eagles lead 8-2. Shot saved by Champagne as we hear the assist read off. So Crocker's going to get an assist, as will Eliza Bowden. And Elmira with an 8-2 lead. A dump in there by Taylor Hamm, collected by Elmira. Turnover, shot is, big slap shot taken, is blocked by Havlin. That one looked like it hurt. She shakes it off, stays on the ice. Beckman centers, no one there. Puck now with Adams. She's got Tolan on the right side. And one more trailing, Adams shot broken up. We got another goal. This one coming from Matthews, her second of the afternoon. She followed up that rebound, punched it into the open netting. It's 9-2, Soaring Eagles. Twelve minutes, 49 seconds on the clock as Elmira makes it a 9-2 game behind Kelly Matthews' second goal of the afternoon. Matthews has scored in each game so far this season for Elmira. And this will be her first multi-goal game of the season. So Jess Adams is going to get the assist on that play as McArdle hits the ice. Looks like she took a knee there while trying to get to that puck. Harris coming out of the back for Elmira. Finds McArdle on the left side. McArdle beats one, but loses it in the process. Morgan Miller had that puck taken off of her, and offside's called. Just about 12 minutes to go in the third period. Lots of goals today in the Soaring Eagles. Shots look like they currently stand at 46-12 in favor of Elmira. Puck sent up ahead to Meter. She dekes one. Leaves it for McArdle. Shot misses wide by Maddie Morton. Morton able to get it back. And a takeaway by Manhattanville, but they lose it just as quickly. Gilman, fresh off the bench. Now back with Manhattanville. Intercepted by McCafferty. Now with Gilman, who is looking for McCafferty again. Can't find her. Sent in by Hansen. Hansen sends it around the boards. Good job keeping that one in their offensive end. McCafferty on the right side. Puck battle in the corner. Let's see who comes away with it. It's going to be Manhattanville, but still battling for it. Gilman with it now. Center pass broken up. She's able to reclaim it. McCafferty steals that to Gilman. One-time attempt by Reva. She's unable to get it. Good look for Elmira on that opportunity. Gilman wraps around. Her shot deflected and goes high into the netting. 10 minutes, 16 seconds to go here in the third period. Both teams changing up their lines as we are just about halfway through this third period with Elmira with a 7-goal lead. Taylor Hamm has the puck taken off her by Haviland. She sends it around the boards to Bowden, up ahead to Crocker. Crocker has Mordini trailing, or on the right side rather. Sends it across, pass broken up. Bowden in the neutral zone with Haviland now. Tip attempt by Crocker, doesn't get very far, but stays in the zone. Now with Bowden to Crocker. She goes low, saved by Girardi. A dump there that allows Newman to get a line change in. Mordini sends it around the boards and Matthews chasing. She's able to get there. Davies is chasing, but she's not going to get there. We're going to have an icing call. 9 minutes, 2 seconds on the clock. And a face-off win for the Soaring Eagles. Adams with it. Now Matthews. Pass broken up by Hannah Beckman. And a takeaway. Elmira coming back the other way. Matthews, center pass broken up. Tolan able to collect it. She curls. A left post shot from Adams. No one home. They're actually a save on that one. Sorry about that, folks. 8 minutes, 22 seconds to go here in the third period. Puck battle out in front of Manhattanville bench, kicked away by a Manhattanville player, but the puck ends up with the Soaring Eagles. Harris trying to shake off a defender. She does. Puck now with Tolan. Sends up ahead to Matthews. She tries to beat one, and Charlotte Stanwood there to take it off of her. Puck upped in the zone by Harris, who sends it around the cage, behind the cage. McArdle is looking for Harris at the point, pass. Harris unable to handle it. Hansen slides it up ahead to Meter. Meter beats one. She goes to the backside of her blade. Save by Girardi. Martignetti. Her pass broken up by Meter. Stays with Manhattanville. Big slap shot by Morton. Follow-up attempt by Meter. But Girardi's all over both attempts. Just under 7 minutes to play here in this third period. Elmira, nine goals. Manhattanville, two. Pass over to Hansen. Now in the slot with Edgington. Her shot misses wide to the right. McArdle. Another centering pass. No one home. Hansen. Fires one in. Looks like it might have been going wide, but it's gloved anyway by Girardi. 6 minutes, 22 seconds to play here in regulation. Soaring Eagles with a 7-goal lead as they look to complete the series sweep against the Valiants. The last time these two teams played at the Murray Athletic Center was last year's UCHC tournament final. The Soaring Eagles coming away with a win after a third period comeback. Unable to see where that run would have went due to COVID-19, our NCAA tournament. Hopes went down the drain, as did the rest of the countries in just about every sport, but we are very happy to be back playing here today and anytime that we can play. 6 minutes, 8 seconds, offensive zone faceoff for Elmira, won by Elmira. Edgington takes a shot, blocked by Morgan Miller. Meter sends it over to McArdle. Finds Heath at the point. Heath sends one in. Saved by Girardi. Lopes had several Elmira defenders on her as she loses it. She's already got 2 goals so far this game. And puck goes into the stands as the whistle calls the play dead with 5 minutes and 18 seconds to go in regulation. And we got a face-off coming up just in front of the Manhattanville bench. Riva has it. Now with Harris at the blue line. She's going to take a shot. Intercepted by Taylor Hamm. Cafford. He can't handle that pass. Tippmann tries to send it into the zone. Hoffman there now with Harris, who went back to Hoffman, but she wasn't there. Four and a half minutes to go in the third period. Elmira with a 7-goal lead still. Riva up ahead to McCafferty. Dumps it for Gilman. Her pass broken up. And a clear by Taylor Hamm, but we're going to get an icing call. 4 minutes and 5 seconds on the game clock. Manhattanville trying to clear it so they get a line change in, but sent it a little too far, and they don't get those fresh bodies back onto the ice. Faceoff win for Manhattanville. As they try to clear again, Elmira able to keep it in. Shot attempt broken up in the slot. Gilman takes it out into the neutral zone. Leaves it for Riva. Riva carries. She's looking. Center pass. Looks like she did find McCafferty, but McCafferty not with much room to get that shot off. As Girardi covers it up at 3:39 in the third period. Another face-off win for Elmira. Crocker with it. Looking for a teammate. Able to find Hansen. Back to Crocker. Crocker goes low. Saved by Girardi. Pass back into the slot. Morton falls while trying to take that shot. Good opportunity there for the Soaring Eagles. 3 minutes to go in this third period. Elmira looking to close this thing out. Morton able to collect that loose puck with Lopes on her back. Turnover. But Elmira able to get it back. And the puck goes out of play again. 2 minutes, 37 seconds to go in regulation. And barring a miracle, the Soaring Eagles are going to pick up their third win of the season. And their third win against UCHC opponents. Soaring Eagles with a 7-1 win yesterday against Manhattanville. And they opened up the year with a 4-1 win at the Murray Athletic Center against Nazareth. Matthews, she's got two goals today already. Matthews sends it along the boards to Tolan. Haviland has it. She drives to the right side. One-time attempt by Matthews broken up. And we're going to have a whistle as the puck's covered up with 1 minute and 50 seconds on the clock. Got to respect the work of Franny Girardi in net today for the Valiants, especially this entire weekend. She's faced a lot of shots and is the only goalie available for the Valiants. She's made 44 saves today to keep this thing as close as it is. action behind the goal as Harris comes away with it. Now with Adams. Near collision at the blue line between Adams and Tolan. Harris has it now. Tolan. She's pushed off the puck. And then sends Meg Stacy to the ice. 1 minute to play in regulation. Here comes McArdle. She's at the right face-off dot. Looking to center a pass, but unable to. She hits the ice. We're going to get a penalty call here coming up shortly as Champagne heads off the ice, but unable to get there. 41.2 seconds on the clock. And we're going to have a Manhattanville penalty coming up in the Soaring Eagles power play. So it's going to be a cross-checking penalty against Holly Meredith. She's going to get 2 minutes in the box. Soaring Eagle is going to head on to the power play again. They've got a few goals with the extra skater this afternoon. And we'll see if they can get another. Morton with a big slap shot. And a save by Girardi. Open net for Millens, and she buries it. 32.8 seconds on the clock. Millens with a power play goal. As Elmire makes it a 10-2 game. So Kelly Millens with the power play goal. Assist going to go to number 18, Maddie Morton. A save by Girardi on a shot from Meter. Tippman with it for Manhattanville. Slides it up ahead to Miller. She takes a shot, saved by Champagne. Martin Yeti sends it around the boards. No one there to collect it as the final horn sounds.